Hello, everyone. Along with Jeff Van Gundy, Mike Breen on hand. Welcome to Staples Center in Los Angeles. It's an NBA Tuesday night on ESPN and EA Sports as we get set for a Pacific Division matchup between the LA Clippers and the Sacramento Kings.
The Kings coming off a tough loss in their previous game against the Clippers. Jeff, they struggled in a lot of areas, but what stood out the most?
That looked like practice out there. There was no hand in their face. There was no contest. There was no running them off the three-point line and making them put it on the ground and try to drive it into the teeth of the defense. This was just poor defensive effort and mentality. A really disappointing loss.
Get your hands up. Here we go.
Able to hit the free throw, and it's a three-point play. Looks to the post. Randolph for two, shoots away. Gallinari's using the screen, trying to get free. From three-point land, and Danilo Gallinari with a bucket from downtown. He's averaging 15 points per game this season.
Sweet stroke on that shot, Mike. It looked good as soon as it left his hand.
Oh, excellent screen. Randolph. Oh, he shoots it. Randolph misses another one. Curls it, and there's a steal. The two defenders converge, lets it go. Randolph misses again.
Hey, you're in a close game. You better guard like your life depended on it. And they did right there, contesting that shot.
Shot clock says 12. Gallinari's trying for low post position. Fires away for two. And Danilo Gallinari with the bucket. He's got 8 points in this matchup. Boy, they need to get something going here. Randolph. And he'll head to the line. There's the whistle. Knocks down the first one. No back-to-back free throws here. He misses the second. Gallinari's trying to get free off the pick. The shot clock down at 12 seconds remaining.
Time is not on their side. What'll they do?
Pretty little pass. Inside. Can't connect from close range.
Hey, that's good offense right there. But if they don't convert those easy shots, their lead will evaporate.
Into the drive. Randolph for two. He rattles it in.
That's a difficult shot right there. The pull-up jump shot off the dribble. Well defended, well contested. Give the credit to the offense.
Looking to curl in. We're down to 11 seconds on the shot clock. Gets inside. That one in and out. There's the pick. And now he moves around the defender. Inside. Count it. And the foul. And he'll head to the line with a chance to complete a three-point play.
That's great body control right there. Finishes the shot and now goes to the free throw line.
Defense doesn't react. They give up the easy basket after the offensive board.
There is absolutely no excuse for giving up an offensive rebound off a free throw. Inexcusable basketball. Just block out, knock your man back, and secure the rebound.
Heal. Can't get it to go from close range. Decker. Still plenty of time. 12 seconds on the shot clock. Hits the three off the catch and shoot. And Sacramento calls timeout here.
Can you say too easy? He is sitting there open at the three-point line and knocks it in.
And Dave Joerger makes a substitution, switching up one of his players. Heal backing his man down. Heal for two, lets it go. Jordan the rebound. And the defense switches. He curls at the rim. Harrell's unable to drop it in off the glass.
Guy goes up in the paint. You have to contest it and make them miss.
To Randolph. Heald's looking for the screen to get himself open. Excellent ball movement around the perimeter. Heald with the left hand. Sweet. A lucky roll off the rim.
Strong move off the dribble penetration to finish at the rim.
He loses control of it, reaches in, taken away by Randolph. Shot clock says 12. He shoots. Ooh, misses the inside shot. Green set nicely from beyond the arc. And the rebound grabbed by Corley Stein. Hill on the drive. Misses at the rim.
Really good job clogging the lane right there.
Entry pass gets it inside. Gets it to go and the foul. And it's on to the free throw line. One shot to complete the three-point play.
Absorbs the contact, finishes the shot, and now works his way to the free throw line.
And he misses that one free throw. Throw line to shoot, and we have a foul called against Decker. First free throw, perfect. Able to convert on both free throws. And he curls in to the basket, flips it up. Soft touch, gets the roll. And as we wind down the quarter, he just fires it up. And the first quarter complete. The Clippers up by four. Stay with us for more NBA on ESPN after a short break.
nice first quarter, nice tight game. This got a chance to be a good one, Jeff.
I'm really excited to see both of these teams, if they can continue to play at this level. Good, solid NBA game right now because both teams playing very well.
Shot clock down at 12 seconds remaining. Not a lot of time for a shot here. Shot clock down to 2. That's from downtown. No go from beyond the arc.
It's hard to close out on great shooters. Tremendous job right there, getting his hand up, mirroring the ball.
Moves around the defender. 8 seconds now on the 24. Ball knocked loose. Comes up with a pretty steal. Ball knocked out of his hands, and it's stolen. In the paint, unable to flip it in.
Driving the ball into the paint is the most important offensive tool in the game. He had a great look. He just missed it.
Goes coast to coast, but can't convert.
To keep a team in sight, you've got to make sure you protect the basket and contest shots.
Oh, excellent screen. To the rim. Nice move. Just won't get it to drop.
Hey, you got to finish strong on those shots. You're right at the basket. You got to put the ball in the hole.
The screen is set. Curling in. Fires away for 2. Nice finish around the rim. And a full timeout is called. Jeff, this is a tough spot for the coach. What does he do?
When you see the full timeout being taken, oftentimes staffs get together away from their teams to do a number of things. One is to discuss necessary strategy adjustments. Maybe they're discussing matchup adjustments. And sometimes the head coach is just complaining about the players who are in the game at that moment. And as an assistant coach, your job is to nod your head. Yes, up and down vigorously, like you understand the pain that the head coach is going through at that moment. Sometimes it is that simple.
We have a substitution being made. Can't find a way through. Shoots it for 2. Just won't go for point blank range. Careless ball handling. Oh, he gets the steal.
The great steal players in this game can anticipate the play before it happens. And this is why he's one of the very best.
Gallinari on the drive. Score the goal and the foul. And now it's one free throw to finish off a three-point play.
That's big-time play right there. Finishing the shot through the contact and now goes to the free throw line.
The free throw, and he completes the three-point play. Screen set nicely. Good setup with the entry pass. There's the double team. Lots of room there. And DeAndre Jordan with his 7th rebound.
That's become a familiar sight, watching him grab rebound after rebound. He's definitely putting in the work.
Randolph. vicious slam.
I like the defense in this possession. Even though the offensive team scored the ball, that was good reaction to come to help protect the basket. Give him credit. He made a nice finish at the rim.
Trying to work it down low.
Trap.
To Gallinari. Shut down, forced to make the pass. Curls in to the basket. Tries to back it, won't go.
Getting the ball to the rim is so important to winning basketball. Great offense, great look, just couldn't knock it in.
Oh, he beats the defender. Hill on the drive, and he'll head to the line with under 2.5 minutes to go in the first half. There's the whistle. Good job to draw the foul. Can't connect on the first free throw. For two from the line. There's a whistle, no question about it. Moving screen right there. Here's the pick. Blows past his man. Getting to the basket, a pretty Euro step. Can't connect from close range.
No paint game, no winning. You've got to get the ball at the basket, and then you've got to finish when you get it there.
Looking to curl in with the runner. Fox can't get that one to go either. Was one brutal screen and no whistle at all. Can't connect, and the lead still in single digits. To Fox. Help defense there with the switch. 10 seconds now on the 24. Looking to dominate down low. Shoots it, he's off balance. Can't get it to go from close range.
Poise and precision will get you a better quality shot than that. That's a bailout shot. That's a, I'm gonna try to get us back in and be a hero type of shot.
Oh, that's finishing strong in traffic.
Very solid basketball. Screen, roll, catch, finish.
Randolph. We're down to 9 seconds on the shot clock. Fox. Nice movement around the perimeter. Throws it up from deep in the corner. Gallinari. Ooh, misses the inside shot. Gets it off. That's a two-pointer. Won't go, the two-pointer. It'll count if it goes. Oh, no good. And that'll do it. First half comes to an end. LA's up by 11. Stay tuned for more ESPN on EA Sports after the break.
Welcome to the EA Sports Halftime Report, brought to you by yours truly, Jalen Rose. The Clippers entered the locker room at halftime with a significant lead. It was their playmaking, the way they gave each other scoring opportunities. That really impresses me. I love seeing unselfish basketball like that. Have a look at the leading scores for the Los Angeles Clippers. The Kings have got themselves in a bad situation that seems likely to only get worse.
At this point, it's all about pride and mental toughness. A comeback is not impossible, but it's also not likely.
These are the guys getting buckets for the Sacramento Kings.
Game track. Field goals.
The Sacramento Kings definitely wouldn't mind having their opponent's field goal percentage. Unlike them, it's been 4 shots and poor effort. It was not a great half. Overall, the efficiency really went from bad to worse in the second quarter.
Player of the half.
DeAndre Jordan looked great in the first half. He was constantly fighting for position in the paint and owning the boards.
Who was cold?
Every player that makes it to the NBA is a great athlete, but even the best players have off nights. Today has just been one of those nights for this guy. Here we go with the top plays from the first half.
Number two. Number one.
The third quarter is about to get started. We give it back now to Mike and Jeff.
Randolph, here's the screen. To the reverse. Sacramento's shooting 42% from the line in tonight's game. Ref blows the whistle. He's got a foul.
You have to post the basketball. It puts maximum pressure on the defense here, backing the man down and drawing the contact.
Jordan the rebound. Second one off the mark. He goes one for two. Gallinari's looking to get free off the screen to Jordan. Puts it up and lays it home.
That's nice body control right there on that layup. Good finish.
Randolph's working hard, trying to back down his opponent. Fires again. And Zach Randolph with a two-pointer.
You're not going to see a better possession in the NBA from both sides of the ball. Good defense, good offense. Good offense won out that time.
Off balance, still gets it off. Able to knock it down. Danilo Gallinari with 13 points. Oh, excellent screen. Puts it up for two. It's good. Jordan's looking for position in the paint. Gallinari. From downtown, in and out. Gets to the rim, makes the adjustment, and gets it to go.
You just got to keep playing the game. Push the ball in transition. You get it to the rim. Good finish. Hey, you've got a big mountain to overcome with this deficit, but you're just trying to win each and every possession.
8 seconds remaining on the shot clock. You're going to have to be quick here. Let's it go. In and out. That one halfway down.
Very well defended right there. Played the whole 24 seconds, contested the shot late to force the miss.
To Gallinari. Tied up and has to pass. Quick move to get inside. Whatever they've got planned, it'll have to be quick. Shot clock down to one. That's a three-pointer. Won't go. And the scoring drought goes over 3 minutes. Pretty crossover setting up the shot from DeAndre Jordan. And we'll have a timeout. They want to talk it over.
Hey, this is why this has turned into a blowout. Poor perimeter defense. Get broken down off the dribble. No help. No basket protection. No chance of winning.
They're going to make some changes with personnel on the floor. Ball comes loose. Oh, he goes for the save there. Oh, that pass way off the mark.
LeBron.
To Randolph. For two.
That's good. Looking for low post position. Nobody near him. Takes the three. LeBissiere, the rebound. Gets it down low. And he throws it down.
Listen, what you want to do right there is catch and gather yourself and get up quickly. It takes what most people wouldn't recognize as good strength and athleticism.
Shot clock shows 10 seconds left. Quick feed back. Not a lot of time for a shot opportunity. In and out. Uh-huh. 11 seconds now on the shot clock.
I got double.
Forced to make the pass. The Clippers with the offensive rebound for another possession. Gets to two. Lucky roll.
Hey, you want to have a good first shot, but it's more important to have the floor balanced so you have enough rebounders who can give you second shot opportunities. Right here, good use of the second shot, not only in getting the rebound, but putting it back in.
Oh, nice rejection by Jordan. And now he moves around the defender. Still plenty of time, 12 seconds on the shot clock. They've got to get this off in a hurry. Tied up, has to make that pass. Oh, scores at the rim. And Sacramento calls time. We'll want to talk it over here. Like some substitutions going to be made now for the team. Into the paint. Denied by Jordan. Pulls up for three. That one halfway down before popping out. Hill on the drive to the rim. Unable to flip it in.
Some might question that shot right there. I like that shot. You have a great player who's a great shooter. I like the creativity. He just missed it.
Banks it in for two.
Sometimes the simplest plays are the hardest ones to execute. Good layup.
And they bring it up. Need to stop the bleeding here. Doesn't count. Stay with us for more NBA action after this short break. It's been an impressive performance as we begin the fourth, but they still have some work to do to get this home win.
They do, but if they continue to grind the possessions out, they'll be fine. They've played very good basketball up until this point. Expect them to continue.
Back in his way down in the post. Shoots it off balance. Strong rebound by Corley Stein.
Three,
clock says 12. Screen set nicely. It's a loose ball. At the rim.
Hey, that's what you got to do late. You got to get the ball in the paint and then finish with strength.
Nice inside pass to the rim. It's good. A two-pointer. Sacramento's down by 10.
Now, when you see these type of plays in slow motion, only then do you realize how graceful and athletic they are.
Strong to the goal. Now time for a couple of free throws. He's fouled.
I really like what I saw there. Good strength, good athleticism, took the foul, got up a nice shot, just didn't roll in.
And he connects on the first free throw. Oh, he misses the second free throw. He goes 1 for 2. Jordan the rebound. Oh, quick move, gets inside. Just won't go for a point blank range.
No paint game, no winning. You've got to get the ball at the basket, and then you've got to finish when you get it there.
LeBissiere is looking to set up in the paint. Pivots toward the rim with the drop step, playing inside out. You're going to have to be quick with this shot. And DeAndre Jordan with his 13th rebound. Perfect entry pass. Shut down, forced to make the pass. Not much time to get this shot off. A pretty entry pass. Decker's bank shot just off the mark.
Driving the ball into the paint is the most important offensive tool in the game. He had a great look. He just missed it.
He puts it up. He rattles it in.
Nice, easy, uncontested two-pointer.
Decker gets in the paint, and the ball gets stripped. And a foul. It's off to the free throw line. That's his second personal foul. Team foul number 2. Oops, missed the first one. Getting it done. Oh, the putback with authority.
See? This is why this team loses games. They take possessions off. Giving up a free throw rebound and a basket is inexcusable.
Looks to the post. It's a loose ball. For 3, off the catch and shoot. The Kings with a 3-pointer, first one of the night.
All kinds of confidence on that 3-pointer. Great looking shot.
Gallinari's using the screen, looking to get free. His man down. Pops it back out to the perimeter. Oh, pretty move into the paint. Can't connect from close range.
Getting the ball to the rim is so important to winning basketball. Great offense, great look. Just couldn't knock it in.
Fires away for 2. Can't get it to go from close range.
You got to figure out how you can get a better quality shot. And he
throws it down.
Good defense, turning into good offense here. Finishing a defensive possession with a rebound and then pushing the ball in transition that leads to a basket to keep and extend the lead.
Nice move into the paint, and he'll head to the line for the second time tonight. And a foul is called. DeAndre Jordan picks up his 2nd of the night.
I love the way the NBA player can contort his body, take contact, and get the ball up to the basket, even when being fouled hard.
misses the first. Continues to struggle from the free throw line. Gallinari's using the screen, trying to get free. 11 seconds remaining on the 24. Puts it up from three-point range as the shot clock goes down to two. Shot clock down at 12 seconds remaining. Lets it go. Oh, he knocks it down. Ball loose, it forces the turnover. Great hands for the steal.
On the drive.
Oh, misses the inside shot. Oh, excellent screen. Ball comes loose. For two. Jump shot for two, won't go.
Defend, defend, defend. Never give in. Good contest. Good closeout. This is the type of defense that they must play.
To the rim.
And it's back to the free throw line for two more free throws. There's a foul. It's called against the Clippers. Their second team foul. Alive. Now just a six-point game. To Gallinari. He curls, attacks the basket, takes the hit, banks it in. What a play! Puts it up, deep corner shot. Oh, in and out. And time runs out. The final score is 43-35. For Jeff Van Gundy and our entire EA Sports crew, this is Mike Breen saying thanks for joining us and good night.
Taylor Rose here, and I've got your EA Sports post-game wrap-up. The Clippers came away with the victory in this one. It was quite a display from long range, and I can't imagine the opposing coach was very happy with how it turned out for them. What you see here is how the majority of the points were scored for the Los Angeles Clippers. The Kings didn't get the victory they wanted here today. And even though some of them smiled and shook hands with the other guys after the game, you can tell by the way they headed to the tunnels how disappointed they were about this loss. Here are the guys who put up the most points for the Sacramento Kings.
Game track. Three-point shooting.
Let's check out the game stats.
Player of the game.
And here we have a look at his stat line.
Who was cold?
What can you say about a guy like this? except that he fits the title of this segment. He was definitely cold in this game. These are the top plays of the game.
Number two. Number one.
This has been a presentation of ESPN on EA Sports. Until next time, I'm Jalen Rose.